float. But I can't plan that far out.
Well, I do offer you a happy hidey-ho from the friendly citizens responsible merchants in Richfield. That is, of course, the hometown in Minnesota. Yeah! Minnesota, where butter is a spice and gravy is a beverage. It's worth it. Is there anyone from Minnesota here tonight? Anyone from really? That doesn't usually happen when we charge admission. Really? Well, new world. All right. Well, I have to say I'm having a wonderful, wonderful time. God, I hope I'm not coming down with anything tonight. I think I'm okay. Well, I have had such a great cruise thus far. Did anyone get off the ship today? Anyone get off the ship? How many of you got off? Yes? Yes, some, yes. And I had been to Mexico before, so I just decided now, you know, really. How many times do you need to see the third world? So I just checked that one off the list. And, but anyway, I'm thrilled to be here. But we're really not talking about Mexico tonight. Maybe a little bit. And we're really not talking about Minnesota tonight very much either. No, you know why? Because I'm going to tell you about a little trip I got planned. Very soon I'm going to Washington, D.C., our nation's capital. And I'm super excited. Well, you see, the colored people are running the show now. Girl! Your mother! Oh, there's one right here. Holy goodness. Isn't that weird? It's pointing out. I can hardly see ya. Just listen for gunshots and hope for the best. Right. Well, they can sit in front now. That President Osama, even his dog is black. It does make you wonder, what color's the help? We'll find that out. But you see, I'm going to get a job. I need to get a job. And I thought, this whole ministry thing is working out on stage, but I have been eating cat food for the last couple months, and Well, last year, I ate the cheap stuff from the grocery store, and it was all blocked up for most of February and the whole of March. On St. Patty's Day. I won't do it again. So I thought I'm going to get a job. And I'm going to, because there's these jobs available. You know, these czars. Czars. That's what they call these jobs. It's, I guess it means, well, I don't know. It must be jive or something. I don't speak a language. I don't know. But anyway, it's all these people are in charge. All these czars. They're all in charge, right? And so I thought, well, I could be in charge of something. And I was thinking, what could I be in charge of? Beauty. I heard it down here. Thank you, beauty. But I've been doing that so long, and I thought, what else could I do? What else could I do? And then I thought, wait a minute. You know, Richfield, my hometown in Minnesota, Richfield has become a many-colored quilt. Which basically means we don't go out after dark. In groups of less than 10, that's for sure. And, you know, kind of a nighttime crowd has moved in. You know what I'm talking about. And I thought, shoot, I'm living around all these new people now. Why don't I become the czar of tolerance? Thank you. And I thought, you know, tonight, I, Miss Richfield, 1981, am taking you all on the chocolate wave that's sweeping the country. Because that White House, she ain't so white anymore. It's a great big world we live in, but no one gets along. Everybody's fighting from St. Paul to Hong Kong. I have a special message. I hope it's not too late. It's time to practice tolerance and live with those we hate. And now so many people are changing their names back. The Indians are natives and the Africans are black. My Oriental neighbors said they're Asian from the start. I call them all Koreans because I can't tell them apart. Get into a nail salon like this. Live with those we hate. Yes, live with those we hate. It's time to practice tolerance and live with those we hate. Everybody's different, and that can irritate. It's time to practice tolerance and live with those we hate. Thank you. Wow! Would you stand up for just a moment? Look at this. Woo! It's a shame we don't have a party to go with that shirt. Here, come up here. But we'll make note of it anyway. Here, come over here, if you could. Then turn around. There you go. There you go. Wow, you couldn't find green, so you got that color. That is, green, sweetie. That's green. Well, what's your first name?
Rick.
Rick! Nice to meet you, Rick. And, I have a hunch that Rick, it might be laundry day for Rick. And you're probably thinking, shoot, wait a minute, I got that green shirt that I forgot to wear for the luau night we had last week. And, I'll be darned, you just got on a day, you look fantastic, you really do, you. I think a floral print is very slimming and wise, they do. I'm not just saying that, Rick. Where are you from, Rick?
San Diego.
I love San Diego! What a beautiful city that is! And now there, where you live and what do you do for work?
I'm a pianist, flutist, pianist, I teach.
Oh, really? Yeah. Well, we like one word answers. Life story, okay? Oh, I got a talker. Well, listen, we're trying to learn something tonight, and if you're talking the whole time, we're not going to be able to do anything. Falling apart up here. Man, listen. Rick. Where you live in San Diego? Rick. I'm wondering, do all the people look just like you? No. Just shake your head. No, they don't, Rick. No. Because you don't look like you have money, so you probably don't live in a nice neighborhood. You live in one of those other neighborhoods where everybody else lives, right? And you look around you and you say to yourself, hey, these people are different. Maybe they're different colored skin, right? We sang about that. Were you listening? We sang about that. And, or maybe they're differently abled. Differently abled, right? Which we still call crippled in Richfield. You have those little big buses, those little clown buses that drive around. You know what I'm saying? You know, with the helmets and the drooling, the bang, bang, bang! Those people! Right? We look at them and we say, they're different, right? But, you know, Rick, there are people who are very different from you, but they look just like you. But they're different. You know why they're different, Rick? Well, they believe in a different God. But they look, you know, let's just cut the crap. Jews. Jews. Now, Mark, can you give me the house line? Hey, can you give me the house line? Thank you, sweetie. Mark is so fantastic. I've got, and by the way, this team of technicians, in case I forget to honor them, can you give them a hand? I'm afraid of it. Mark is up there. And, some Mexican coming soon. But you know who you are. He's the one with the sombrero. Oh, you took it off. Backstage, we've got one. They're just a really nice team of people. Now, here, I'm going to show you what I mean. I said that, but I'm going to teach you now. Now, I want all the Jews to raise their hand. Look, look, all the Jews. Look. They look normal. Look at. And yes, you can put your hands down. And, they're very colorful people, the Jews, but never colored. That's the weird thing. I know. And I'm thinking, where you're from in San Diego, I bet there are a lot of churches. Maybe even a Jewish church. I don't know. I haven't been to San Diego in his neighborhood. But you know what, Rick? There's only one Jesus! The topic of our Lord above is troubling to me, because some don't revere him, and some think he's a she. Catholics pray to Mary, Jews put Jesus in a tomb. Don't joke about Mohammed, or you'll hear a big kaboom! The friends of mine in wheelchairs require special care. They seem to crave attention, so feel free to point and stare. And blind folks who use canes to see might get you in a crowd. Remember, they can't see a thing, so talk to them real loud! Live with those we hate, yes, live with those we hate. It's time to practice tolerance and live with those we hate. Everybody's different and that can irritate. It's time to practice tolerance and live with those we hate. Stand up for just a minute if you would. Come over here. Oh.
Look at, I think she could give Tits O'Reilly a run for her money. We're gonna have you keep them in there for tonight. The blouses are nice, really.
What are you doing?
Very nice. And what's your first name?
Cheryl.
Cheryl, you're our second stop on our Tolerance Express! All right, now. Where are you from?
Michigan.
From Michigan. Wonderful, wonderful, wonderful. Well, this sleeveless, I mean, wow. Very brave, very brave. And, well, now, is it, what was your name again?
Cheryl.
I didn't love the tone. I know I make this look easy, Cheryl. Up here. I know. I mean, first song is three verses, which is two more than usual. Well, you know that. So anyway, now Cheryl, you're from Michigan. Where in Michigan are you from?
Grand Rapids.
From Grand Rapids. Wonderful. Oh, that's right. My nephew. I have to find out where my nephew teaches school. I'll tell you where they teach school. And she works in school, which involves children. So we're gonna move on. And I'm wondering now, Cheryl. Now, if you could maybe just stop drinking for a couple of days. You're holding on to the stage for dear life, my dear.
I know, I know.
What do you think would make you a more tolerant person? Yeah, we don't have that kind of time, so we have the room till 1:30. So I'm going to give you an idea to help you, okay? Maybe if you were more specific about the type of people you hate, right? We already used the Jews, and they're such a good example. Shoot. Who hasn't been fighting with them lately? Really? Think about it. I'll think of somebody else. Just give me a second. Hang on. I got one. Homos. Difficult people. Difficult. And let's just see how many homos are here tonight. Just the homos. More than half. Actually, kill the house lights, Mark. It's kind of a frightening thing, seeing their faces and all. Blank looks are killing me. Anyway, so now, listen. You know how difficult the homos can be. Are you traveling with homo?
Yes.
Well, then you know how difficult. It's like having a pet chimpanzee. It's me, 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 you know how you people are. And we're always raising money for their poor personal decision making. I mean, we are. But you know, they do, they dress so nicely, and they sing like birds. Thank you. The fellows. Now the gals. They like to dress down a little bit more, don't they? But you've never met a handier group of gals in your life! Thank you, Sarah. So what about the day when you fix your broken bike? You call a sturdy lesbian, but please don't call her dyke. And all gay men are in floors and parade around in drag. They're heterosexually challenged and salute a rainbow flag. Cause you love color, don't you? You do. So each of us is different in every kind of way. Acknowledge this to others with the things you do and say. Like walking home at night from a movie or museum. You might say to a stranger, keep your hands where I can see them. Oh, you know, let people know where you stand, right? Okay, here we go. Live with those we hate, yeah, live with those we hate. It's time to practice tolerance and live with those we hate. Everybody's different and that's a guarantee. It's time to practice tolerance and live with those we hate. Oh, wait a minute now! It's a sing-along, everybody! Live with those we hate, live with those we hate. Sing-along, it's time to practice tolerance. Holy crap, that feels good. I love it when I nail the opening number. Well, I know many of you who are like Cheryl, plain and untalented. You're probably looking up here and you're saying to yourself, her outfit is darling. I mean, it really is darling. And does she always wear sleeveless? And doesn't she usually belt her outfits? And does it come with slacks? You know, I pretty much heard it all. But actually, you may not realize that this outfit is an exact replica of our world.
Oh, shut up.
Thank you. And yes, I got it in the children's department. It's clearly an adult size. I don't know when. Anyway, and it came with a little booklet. And so I was learning about our world. I was reading this because I took the Greyhound from Minneapolis to Fort Lauderdale. And so I had about 6 or 7 days on the bus. So I had some time to read. And I learned things about our world I did not know. Like what's inside the world? I didn't know. I thought maybe a yoke. Oh, no, stairs to China. Yeah, us women are. We share a brain. We don't know. And but you know what's inside the world? You know what's inside the world? Burning hot lava. Now it is burning up in there, and coincidentally, so am I tonight. So I am going to have to run and scratch in the sandbox real quick. And so, guys, Mark and the Mexican, you know what, we're just going to have to, I know we spent 10 minutes putting this together this afternoon, but take both of the 3x5 cards, just take both of them and throw them away. We're going to have to redo the whole show. And I'm sorry, that itching came back and I can't get at it with this on, that's for sure. So I'm going to have to run backstage. And I hope we can show another one of our educational presentations. This particular presentation is very important. It introduces a topic that, well, it's integral to this portion of our evening because the chill, you know what, I'm gonna poop in my pants. Just, you know, hit play. Between shows, if you get the 409 and a putty knife, I think we should do it straight back clean. Anyway, we'll go dry by then. So, now, grabbed the first thing I had, which was my house coat, so I apologize, but this is a very important time. This is an important subject. It is speaking the language of others. So if we are living in a world of tolerance, and we are living with people we hate, how do you expect to tell people you don't like them if you don't speak their language, right? That's why this is such an important exercise this evening. And what I'd like to do tonight is, oh my word, we've got, oh, it's just a sea of humanity out there. Look at that. And look at the gal. Hi, how are you? Oh, what's her name?
Nellie.
Oh, Nellie, look at you sitting next to Tits and Lorraine, her husband. Could you come and join me for just a moment, darling? It won't take but a minute. Come on, Lorraine. Tits O'Reilly, we'd have her up here, but, well, I'd have to charge you all $5 more. So come this way, sweetie, come this way. And as you're going to, here we go. Come along, sweetie. Here we go. I know you're not wearing dress shoes. It shouldn't take this long. Okay, and then as you're going through, Pick up the brother on the way through. Here we go. Come here, sweetie. Come on. I usually come down and get people, but you all were just sitting in such great. So good heavens. Hello. Here, let's go over here. Oh my, look at it. Oh, well, you're just lovely. Now, over here, sweetie. Come along. He is lovely, isn't he? I know. So what's your first name?
Reggie.
And where are you from?
Philly.
And what do you do for work?
I'm an engineer.
And have you been with Atlantis events before?
Yes.
And do you have a boyfriend?
No.
And I didn't catch any of that. I don't speak jive. So, who cares? Who needs to understand it when you look like that? And what's your name again? Now, I'm going to need that chair over
great?
There. And she's dressed for it, sweetie. Let her down. Depressed and all looking fantastic, and she's a wrinkled mess, oh my word. And then just set the chair down there next to this chair, sweetie, next to this chair, there we go. Yes, I like the lesbians to set my furniture, because the homos would have put that at a jaunty angle. Come on, bright yellow chair, which looks very comfortable. And then you get over here, right here. Let's go. Come on. Giddy up. Here we go. All right, come on. Sit it. There we go. All right, now. It's always a big time in the program when Miss Richfield, 1981, pulls out her furry sack. So yes, you're lucky to be in this portion. Yes, because sometimes it just falls out, and other times, like tonight, I really had to give it a yank. How many of you have furry sacks of your own? Lorraine and the Jews, that's it. Well, you don't ask, right? So in here is a surprise tonight that's going to help us, because you know what we're going to do? And this is going to be fun, you're going to enjoy this. We're going to have a good old-fashioned spelling bee. A good old-fashioned spelling bee. So it doesn't even matter that your hair looks like that. Anything with beauty or looking good. It's just about learning to spell. Smarter, so we're gonna have you slip into these. We've got a pair for each of you, and I just think if you look smarter, it helps to spell better, don't you think? And slip into the. Woo! Look how they show up on you. Yeah. Real nice. We say in bingo, hot dog, we've got a wiener right here. He is handsome, isn't he? I mean, you hate men, and you have to admit he's a good-looking one, isn't he? So. Now, I am gonna explain the rules now, and I'm gonna need two hands for this, so I'm gonna set down my handbag, and I think it's a good time to announce that I'm not carrying any cash, okay? Now, have you been in a spelling bee before? You have not, and I bet you, have you been in a spelling bee before? You have. Oh, so it's just a review for you. You've done this before. Okay. Well, let me tell you. What's going to happen is I'm going to have a word. And I'm going to spell it. No, you're going to spell it. Oh, I can't even think. I'm so nervous. It's okay. There we go. All right, there we go. Here's how it goes. You'll see, I'll say the word, okay? And then I'll have a sentence. You might not know the word. You might be confused, right? And then I'll teach a hand motion.
Repeat the word, because I always repeat myself. That's why the 35-minute programs always last 90.
And because I do like to repeat myself. And then we'll have you spell the word. Now, if you spell the word correctly, you'll hear this. Very good. Now, if you spell the word incorrectly, you'll hear this.
Steer-right!
Ooh, we don't want to hear that tonight, do we? No, we don't. And it's 1 point per word, the first one to 100 wins. So, it's going to be lots of fun. Well, there you are. Yeah, I just explained all the rules. I don't have time to go over here. If you weren't going to cooperate, you should volunteer. All right, well, it's too late now. Now, okay. So let's start, and we're going to do ladies first. Well, we're going to go with you anyway. Oh, my hair is splinter. These come from all the different worlds, right? All over the world. Foreign, you know, local, all the words. And our first word comes from our friends, the homos. Right, the first word comes from the homos. Now, you know homos, don't you, sweet? You're traveling with some, I would assume, aren't you?
Many.
So you know this. So maybe this is going to give you this will be a good first word for you, okay? Because we'll give you a chance to get ahead, pull ahead right at the beginning. And our first word that you'll be spelling is the word, no, don't look! Sister, you can't look, sweetie. See, you got to spell the word. If you see it, that sort of takes the fun out of the game. So keep facing forward. The word is sister. Okay, do you want me to use it in a sentence? I'll use it in a sentence. You look confused. Okay, just listen. Even though they're both middle-aged white men and roommates for more than 20 years, Thomas and Stefan call each other sister. There are some homos here tonight, that's good. And there's a hand motion for this, because you know, when you're speaking the language of others, right, Nellie, that you might mispronounce that word, like the homos say it with like 15 S's in it, but that's not how it's spelled, right? And so the hand motion is quite easy. Right hand, left hand, right hand, okay. And you go click, click, click. Okay, try that. Just try it, sweetie, can you? No. No, I'll show you what I mean. If any of the homos out there, you try it. Ready? On three. One, two, three. Yeah, any of those examples would be in there. About, do it again. I think you. She got it. Okay. That's it. Now we're going to spell the word, and then you're going to do the hand motion after you spell it. The word again is?
Sister.
F-U. Sister now.
S-I-S-T-E-R.
Now do the hand motion. Yeah! Now let's see what the judges say. See? Now you get the point and you play by the rules, you crazy, crazy chick. All right, Nellie. Oh, dear. I think she was going to spell a bad word. We can't have that. My church pays for my bus fare. I can't have that. You know how that goes, sweetie. All right, now Leroy, I'm wondering, to be honest with you, have you ever been to south of the border?
Yes.
You haven't? Oh, that's good. That's real good. That's going to give you an edge up, just like she knows the homos. Because our next word comes from our friends, the Mexicans. Now, You may say to yourself, well, I've been to Mexico, but I don't speak Mexican. So that may be going to be, but you know what? I have practiced this word. I have practiced this word. You're going to hear every syllable, every letter you're going to hear, okay? So I'll do my very best. So I think you're going to be able to spell this, whether you speak it or not. Our Mexican word you're going to spell tonight is the word fence. 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 You don't need to use it in a sentence. You look confused. Okay, let's use it. Okay. It was about midnight when Josie, his family, and 43 of their friends stepped out of the back of a truck and realized they had to scale the George W. Bush Memorial. Yes. Shaking the rockers and spinning around the fabulous. So now the hand motion for this, very easy. Okay, you put both hands in the air. You never have to tell them twice. You people. Oh. Well, anyway. But when you do it, you have to look surprised, like, real surprise. Try that. Real surprise. Yeah, that's it. You have to look that look like, this is the third time we've tried this. My niece is waiting at the 7-Eleven in El Paso. That kind of look, you know? And so now we're going to have you spell the word, okay? And spell the word, and I said it, all right? And then do the hand motion. Again, the word is fence. Do your best.
F-E-N-C-E.
And the hand motion. Oh, and the judges say? Careful, I mean, it's all tied up, see, look at this. All right. Now, do you have any brothers that live in your neighborhood?
No.
Well, that's too bad, because our next word comes from our friends who speak the jive. I know, look at her. She's like, ooh, that first one was easy. This is going to be difficult, but just focus now, sweetie. The jive word you're going to speak tonight is the word axe. Okay, Nelly? You look distressed. You want me to use it? I'll use it in a sentence. Just listen, okay? In order to find the Colt 45, Katrina said she would go to the counter and ask the word. And you keep to yourself. Better do her own work. Do not help her. Very helpful. Now the hand motion for this. Now remember the hand motion for sister, just to review, it's click, click, click. She's got that. She's so got that. And then the hand motion for the axe is two-handed. It goes like this. Okay. Ooh, man, you've got that one right away. That's perfect. Okay. Jeez, I mean, just see that? The homo in front drying his eyes. It was scary. That was perfect. Thank you. You kind of look like you're going to take their money. It's perfect. Now, so we're going to have you spell the word, and then do that hand motion, just like you just did. The word again is... axe. Okay, do your best, sweetie. You can do it now.
A-X-E.
And the judges say... He's like, am I going to be able to pull this out or not? Now, what kind of shoes you wearing there? Ooh, those look like brand new sneakers. You might want to take those off. Because we're going to the desert for our next word from our friends, the Muslims. Now, do you know any Muslims of your own? Do you have a Muslim, a personal Muslim on staff?
No, I don't.
No, okay, well, it doesn't matter. Because as long as you watch the news, you keep up, because these are the people, the Muslims are always on the news, they're the people in the long robes overseas, they're always throwing rocks. I'm not exactly sure why they're always so upset, but they are, they're always upset about some, well, you people get them started, and then the rest of us are all in. You know, your fault. I mean, when you name your religion after a fabric, I mean... You're not all right, you know what I'm saying? All right. So, the Muslim word you're going to spell tonight is the word... Hand, okay, just like that, and then put one finger in each ear. Yeah. Because when you hear that, you're gonna wanna do that. Okay? Now, we're gonna have you spell the word and then do the hand motion. Again, the word is. I think we should go into our rapid-fire bonus round, which happens to be worth 98 points tonight! So it's anybody's game, we're pulling for you. All right. Now, here's the story on this. This particular word, this bonus word that we're going to do tonight, and you just get one chance, okay? This bonus word was made famous by a great lady of song. I speak, of course, the fabulous Aretha Franklin. Who loves Aretha? Fabulous. And she sang at Osama's big parade, you know, when he was just elected, so, you know, 3, 4, 5 years ago. Remember that? And she got up there and she sang that song. I think she sang My Country, 'Tis of Thee, and it was so beautiful. She's such a beautiful voice. And she had on a hat. Do you remember? She had a hat on. Do you remember? She had a hat on. And do you remember? Yes, of course, you do. And there was something big on the hat. Does anyone remember what it was? What was it? A bow. A great, and it was a big bow. It was big on her, and she's big. Yep. So, you can imagine the size of the actual bow. I mean, you couldn't see the Capitol for about 5 minutes, really. I mean, I don't know if you remember, but the point is that this word that she made famous is perfect for a show on tolerance. Because the word is...
respect.
Respect! That's right! What you say, oh Nelly, you spell it! What you say, oh Ramon, you sell it! All I'm asking for is for a little respect. Here, come do the choreography with me. You get extra points. Now you've got natural rhythm. Don't pull ahead. Here we go. The homos are calling out, sis. And the Mexicans are climbing like it's climb plenty. But all they're really climbing for is for a little respect. Do the sisters. Click, click, click. There you go. Do the Mexicans. Do the sisters. Click, click, click. Do the Mexicans. The Africans are asking and asking. The Muslims are, they are going to kill us all. And all they really want, a little respect. Do the yo. Do the R-E-S-P-E-C-T, isn't this our spelling bee? R-E-S-P-E-C-T, celebrate diversity. What do we got up here? We got some chocolate love and single and looking good. And her. So, get to know everybody. Right? We turn the White House brown. Now anything goes down. say this every night, but I have never seen anyone just move so naturally and try so hard. And so, let's give it up one more time for our fabulous
Reggie.
Well, I know you're... Oh, I think I'll just leave this here. You know, I know you're probably thinking, wow, how is she going to wrap up this overly rehearsed, tightly scripted, high-quality production this evening? I mean, is there more? Yes, there is just a little bit more, because I need to wrap this up. I need to pull it together. I need to take these loose ends, drive it home, and I don't think anyone does it better than our children. So if you have a paper and pencil, take notes. This is a real important one. Go ahead, Mark, sweetie. Christmas trees down there. Look at finally something we can understand. All the other homos are like, what is that? It's a handsaw. Can ask a tips about it later. But she'll explain. So anyway, I want to close out this evening. Oh, I didn't need this though. Why did I bring this? I made a trip I didn't need to make there. I want to just sit down for a moment and tell you about this song that's going to work out so well to wrap this up this evening. Because this is the show I will be taking to the White House. I will be doing This Is The Show. It's pretty finely tuned now. And I'm going to the front door, not the side like Katie Kirk does. I'm going to go right to the front door. And I'm going to ask for Osama by name and just see what happens. You know. So I want to do this show. I hope that they learn something when I do it for them in Washington, and I hope you've learned something tonight in our educational presentation. Maybe you've learned some new people to hate. I don't know. I don't know how deeply you got involved, but hopefully you were paying attention. And I'm going to have the president listen to the show. I'm going to invite Michelle and the chillin', as you call them. We're going to have them all gather and see the presentation. And this is how I'm going to end it, with this song that talks about color. And we talked about color, actually, quite a bit tonight. And this is where color goes across the sky after a terrible, terrible rainstorm. It goes across the sky. And what do we call that?
Rainbow.
I was thinking tornado, but anyway, I was about another 10 minutes I was going to get to rainbow. But anyway, well, you jumped ahead. We'll just move ahead. But yeah, rainbow is kind of where I was going eventually. And rainbow is pretty because it's not one color, right? It's not two colors, right? It's all the colors, and they're all touchy. All 11, 12, 13, however many colors going across the sky, all of them, all the colors. Well, not brown. There's no brown in the rainbow, is there? You people are left out of everything. Sad, isn't it? I know. Well, anyway, well, you ruined my introduction, but I'm going to do the song anyway. Okay? You're going to love this now. Okay. Now, don't hit
start.
Woo!
Oh,